Jim Weber with a new sport update. The Nolan Ryan Express got back on track Monday. Baseball's all-time strikeout king returning off the DL to blow past the Brewers. In his 27th and final year, Ryan's shining in his first start since May the 7th.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a very major surprise coming up from Paul E. Dangerously and Freddie Gilbert coming up at Ultra Class Number 1 on September 18th. If any members of the media have any questions at this time, please feel free to... Yes, come in. We're in a press conference here.
Mr. Gordon, there's a small problem outside. There's someone named Mr. Gilbert who insists on coming in here.
You tell Mr. Gilbert that number one, this is a board of directors meeting. Number two, we're in the middle of a press conference. And number three, he can take that up, any questions or problems he has with us at the office. Okay?
Great.
This is not the place for Mr. Gilbert. All right.
Hi. Thank you.
Excuse us for that interruption, ladies and gentlemen. Number three, this involves every member of this federation. A fine has been levied against every single wrestler who left the dressing room area last week for that brawl that you saw on television. I warned them about this type of incident, and maybe now they'll believe me. In fact, let's take a look at this incident right now.
Elbow! This is incredible, Tod Gordon. What's going on here? I've never seen anything like this. Funk, the Super Destroyer's in the ring now. Osborne with Rebel outside the ring. Here comes Wild Man Sal, elbow to the dress. Get on the head of Donovan Hotbody.
What's going on here?
Tod Gordon, you've got to gain some control. You've got to do something about this, Tod Gordon.
This is getting out of hand, fellas.
Glenn
Osborne, stop this mess.
We've got, this is unbelievable. Things have totally broken down here, man. Sal Palomo with a trash can over the head of Sir Richard Michaels. Here comes Tony Stetson.
Let's go. Break this up. Let's go. It's going to be fine. And there's going to be suspensions. I want this broken up right now. Right now, you break it up, everyone here.
In the case of Wild Man Sal Palomo, the board of directors and myself are weighing a possible suspension. However, we have received hundreds of letters from younger fans stating that it was indeed an accident on Palomo's part, and they're requesting leniency. And we are taking this under advisement. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, number four. This is not the WWF. This is not the WCW or the NWA, and thank God it's not the USWA or Globe or anything like that either. But we will not allow three men to defend belts in our federation. When someone wins a tag team title, that means two gentlemen defend the belt. We will not have people interchanging as though they just run the federation by their own rules. And we've gotten together here and we've decided that yes, indeed, because of that changing of partners, we are stripping the suicide blonde of the tag team titles. We are putting down the hammer, we are laying down the law, and we will have a tournament that will be seen right here on Sports Channel starting in a few short weeks for the tag team titles. The Suicide Blondes are no longer the tag team champions as of today. Yes, Mr. After, I believe you had some questions regarding what we're talking about with the tag team tournament. Yeah. Yes, come in. Here we go.
Mr. Gordon, this man is intolerable. He's insisting on coming in here. Eddie Gilbert, can I let him in?
No, you may not let him in. You may not come into this meeting. He has no business being here. As I said, he can see us at the offices, and you can tell Mr. Gilbert to please leave or have him physically removed.
He's not being cooperative.
Well, you'll just have to tell him. We're in the middle of a press conference. He's not welcome here today.
Okay.
You know, as we all know what's been going on here, I mean, for those of you at home who haven't seen, you know, the past weeks of this show, we've got a major problem on our hands here with a Mr. Eddie Gilbert, who has proclaimed himself to be the King of Philadelphia. He walks around the streets of Philadelphia wearing a crown, wearing a cape, challenging people to fight on the street, causing scenes in clubs and bars. A lot of people know about the incident between he and John Crux. He was seen at the vet stadium not too long ago, throwing eggs at Randall Cunningham's car. You remember what that cost us. Then, of course, there was an incident with Ron Jaworski, which we'll be seeing on today's program between Ron Jaworski and Mr. Eddie Gilbert. And I have to tell you, people at home, if any of you should happen to see this fool of a man on the streets of Philadelphia, please understand that anything he says does not represent the opinions or the feelings of Eastern Championship Wrestling or this board of directors. This man is working on his own. He is in his own, you know, realm somewhere. I don't know what he's thinking, but believe me, his opinions do not represent the opinions of anyone here at the ECW. Yes, Mr. Keller, I believe you have some questions you want to ask. Yes.
He won't listen to me. He's insisting on coming in.
Excuse me, please. All right, listen.
Hello, everybody. First off, I want to know, why don't you go ahead and start driving Social Security somewhere? Listen, how come you don't let me know about the board director's meeting? Everyone knows that I'm part of this now. Actually, I probably own part of this company. Besides, I should know about these things. I have decisions that need to be made. And also, I want to know something, Mr. Gordon.
We're not going to embarrass this company in front of the media. We want you out of your
office. How can I embarrass the company? You already done too good of a job for that. Listen, who am I wrestling off your past anyway? I heard Stan Hansen's going to be there. Am I wrestling him? Am I wrestling Abdul the Butcher? I heard Terry Fox's name mentioned. I heard Hawk. What do you got down
there? You will find out when you
wrestle
this media.
Give me that.
That's enough.
Cut off.
Cut off.
Okay, so get this man out of here now.
I want to look right
now. No, I should listen to me. I'm the king.
Carter W. Reed, corner of 10th and Sansom Street, since 1860.
Dick Gregory for the Bahamian Diet.
The problem is you're overweight, whether it's 10 pounds or 150 pounds. Hey, I've been there, and the solution is simple. The Bahamian Diet. Mix it with fruit juice, drink it for breakfast and lunch, eat a well-balanced meal for dinner, drink 8 glasses of water every day, and walk a mile every day. Hey, that's all there is to it. Don't wait. Start right now. You can do it. I know. I've been there. It ain't pretty.
Available at GNC and most health stores.
The number one selling trucks are only at your Quality Plus Ford dealer.
No other truck is built for
the quality built Ford Explorer, the number one selling truck in its class, has more overall passenger and cargo space for more room and comfort for the whole family. Explorers at home on the highway or off the road. Loaded with extras, save up to $1,900. 5 of the top 10 bestsellers in America, including Ford Explorer, are at your Quality Plus Ford dealer.
You better hit the ground running in the new Ford truck. Hey, hey.
This is Paul E. Dangerously. Not that I need an introduction, but if you want to know the latest in the ECW, pick up your phone. Dial 215-544-0421. How's that, huh?
Eddie, we're on. Eddie.
Oh, okay. Hello, everyone. Just sitting here reading. I don't know if everyone got their copy of the Philadelphia Daily News this week with, hey, man, what's this guy named? Sue Bykowski?
Bykowski.
Bykowski, yeah. Sue Bykowski. Anyway, he got the story all wrong here anyway. Me and Ron Jaworski got to a little spat, and I just kind of kicked his rear and everything. But to all you disbelievers out there, yes, I am a special host this week of ECW Wrestling. You're king. Everyone's king of Philadelphia. Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert. And you know, I'm sure you're wondering, where is Tod Gordon? Well, Tod's down at Carver W. Reed trying to sell some jewelry. And, well, Jay Sully couldn't be here today because he's out selling vacuum cleaners. And, well, our ring announcer, Bob Ortiz, well, besides the fact that his wife wears the pants in the family, wouldn't let him out, he's out unplugging a sewer somewhere over in Springfield. And, of course, there's Matthew Ritico, our director, who's behind the camera right now, trying to tell me how to do this job. I know you people are really excited about this show because you have me and not Jay Sully or not any other loudmouth out here think they know anything about wrestling. This is going to be the greatest show you've ever seen. You're going to be seeing the adventures of the King of Wrestling today. You're also going to be seeing something that I am looking forward to, a match between the Sandman and Johnny Hotbody, and Miss Peaches is going to get something revealed. You know what I mean? You get it? Huh? Huh? Understand? Yeah. Also, one little thing I want to say to Mr. Tod Gordon. He made a fool out of me, or tried to, and tried to embarrass me in just a segment you just saw in a press conference. No one does that to me. This is my city now, just like Ron Jaworski, just like Randall Cunningham, and just like every other sporting legend throughout this city is going to realize and going to see. He tried to strip, and did strip, the Suicide Bronze of tag team titles. Well, Tod, you can't strip me of the crown because I'm the king of Philadelphia. And I want everyone to stay tuned with this little commercial right now. When we come back, you'll be seeing the adventures of the king of Philadelphia.
Don't forget, fans, the next ECW television taping extravaganza, August 7th and 8th at the ECW Arena. Starting time, 7 p.m. both nights. The bad man from Borger, Texas returns. The man who broke Bruno's neck, Dan the Lariat Hansen, is back. Formerly one half of the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Shane Douglas makes his ECW debut. Self-proclaimed King of Philadelphia, hot stuff Eddie Gilbert returns from his tour of Philadelphia to defend his crown. Former WWF Intercontinental and Tag Team Champion Tito Santana will be in action. Sensational Sherry makes her ECW debut. Paulie Dangerously, along with a whole Dangerous Alliance, including heavyweight champ, the Magnificent Morocco, TV champion, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, and the mysterious Dark Patriot. Ivan and Vladimir Koloff return, and of course, the wild man, Sal Balomo, will be there to greet all the kids. A two-night tournament to crown the new ECW Tag Team Champions, along with all the other top stars in the ECW. That's August 7th and 8th at the ECW Arena in South Philadelphia, 7 p.m. bell time. For more information, call the ECW hotline at 544-0421. The action's going to be hot, August 7th and 8th.
To reshape the body is a relatively simple procedure. You begin by removing the excess from one area and molding it into muscle in a more desirable position. This may be easily accomplished by use of a simple household apparatus, the Soliflex Fitness Machine, just $39 a month. What are you waiting for?
Bravo! An exclusive selection of American independent and award-winning films. Bravo. Music, dance, and theater from the classics to the cutting edge. Bravo. Bringing you backstage to meet today's hottest stars, top artists, and acclaimed filmmakers. Cable television's only cultural center for the dramatic and performing arts. Bravo. Culture television.
One thing a professional painter could say to a do-it-yourselfer is this. Don't do it yourself. Get some help.
Ask Sherwin Williams. The answer? Good paint, good price, good advice. Guaranteed.
I rely on these guys for almost everything.
You know, a professional painting crew wouldn't even start a job until they got all the help they need.
You shouldn't either.
Pros, no. Ask Sherwin Williams.
Today, a man came into the bank for a $500 loan. $500. Banks don't make loans that small. It's just too much paperwork. I told him, try a collateral loan. A pawnbroker. No paperwork and very fair interest rates. He said, pawnbrokers, are they reliable? I said, certainly. It's like any other business. You just have to be careful who you deal with.
Carver W. Reed, corner of 10th and Sansom Street, since 1860.
I'm sorry. I have to apologize just a second. You know what? This reminds me, I'm just sitting here watching myself as clobber Terry Funk in the great summer Super Sizzler Spectacular that happened June 19th at the ECW Arena. You haven't ordered your copy of this tape yet. You better do so now because there's only just a very few copies still left, and you better order it now, okay? But now is what everyone throughout Philadelphia is talking and raving about. I'm getting the greatest raves and ratings and people everywhere I go. From a picture where I live and where I walk and where I talk and where I go to eat, everyone's talking about The Adventures of the King of Philadelphia. So I want you to watch right now, and Matt, get this right. Let's see The Adventures of the King of Philadelphia.
ECW Heavyweight Champion, The Rock, Don Morocco. Welcome, Don, to the Eagle's Nest.
Well, I'm sure it's all your pleasure having me here. And it's I'm doing a little spotting for Hot Stuff International as we watch it. Terry, what's his name here?
The living legend, Terry Funk. You know who that is, Don Morocco, facing off against that wild man himself, the Canadian Wolfman.
You know, Terry Funk has undertaken a giant task here coming to the ECW. He's looking at Hot Stuff International. He's run into it head on.
Well,
he's got a lot of trouble coming for him.
Yeah, if there's anybody who can handle themselves, Don Morocco, I think it's Terry Funk. You know that as well as I do.
I grant it, Terry Funk used to be a great wrestler. Terry Funk used to be a great competitor. But he spent all these years in Hollywood, all these years making movies and television, that he's lost the edge he once had. You can see this right now. The Wolfman is running circles around him.
I have to disagree with you there, Rock. Terry Funk, they may call him the living legend, but his days are hardly over in the ring. Still an incredible competitor and a welcome one here in the ECW. Working over that left arm of the Canadian Wolfman, working on that shoulder area, Don.
He still knows how to attack the pressure points. He still knows how to stretch them and bend them.
It's Canadian Wolfman. He's a tough competitor, but I don't know if he's any match for the living legend, Terry Funk.
Well, if he's as tough as he is ugly, Funk is in for a long night.
I'll stay away from that one, Don. No comment, man.
I heard you got a couple tattoos like that, too, on your chest.
Not me, Don Morocco.
Maybe you'd like me to put a couple there for you.
No, thank you. No, thank you. Oh, a rake of the eyes by the Canadian Wolfman on Terry Funk.
Beautiful scientific moves.
The Funker's not going to like that one. Firing back with an elbow. Another elbow. Terry Funk now getting ready to whip the Wolfman across the ring. Is he going to follow it up? Oh, yes, with a big left elbow on the top of the head of the Canadian Wolfman. Oh, gets the big man up for a body slam. What do you think of that, Tom Morocco?
I think we better call a doctor. I think he just got a hernia there.
Up again, a second big body slam by Terry Funk.
He doesn't know when to quit. I certainly can't tell you that much.
That says a lot about the strength of Terry Funk. I didn't think he'd be able to get this big man up. And a third time, yes, a third body slam.
He's just showing off now.
Oh, and a nice leg drop by Terry Funk. And a cover. There's one. There's two. Oh, the Canadian Wolfman kicking out of the
count. Great resiliency. You can tell all the hours he puts into the gym training and working out. Look at the striations in his abdominal section.
Are we looking at the same wrestler, Don Morocco? Are you kidding me? The Canadian Wolfman spending time in the gym? I don't think so.
When you spend your time with Hot Stuff International, the whole world, you look through rose-colored glasses.
Spinning toe hold by Terry Funk, one of his patented moves.
The famous Funk spinning toe hold, that's been around for years and years.
And there's the bell. Yes, the Canadian Wolfman unable to hang on. Terry Funk, the victory by submission over the Canadian Wolfman. Terry Funk, the living legend.
Look, all that time in Hollywood, he still can't find the camera.
He's just coming to ringside. And we've got the Dark Patriot and Jimmy Superfly Snuka along with Paulie Dangerously. These are associates of yours, Don Morocco. What's going on here?
Hot Stuff International has hit ECW.
Oh, who's that? Terry Funk?
Who's
that?
This?
It's Road Warrior Hawk.
What the hell is he doing here?
Road Warrior Hawk, he's coming
around. He's not supposed to be here.
Incredible.
He
can't even see. Get that man out of the building. He has no business here. He doesn't belong here. What's he doing here? Right. We put him in the hospital. He's gone for good.
He's back, Don Morocco, Road Warrior Hawk. That face is taped up, and we saw why just a couple weeks ago here in the ECW. But he's back. He's in the ring with Terry Funk.
He has no business here. He shouldn't be here. He should be in a hospital. He should be in a mental ward. He doesn't belong here one bit. Get that man out of here. Terry Funk and the Road Warrior. I can't believe it. Terry Funk and Hawk the Warrior. Hawk the War Warrior.
Terry Funk, Road Warrior Hawk, standing tall here.
Eddie Gilbert, you and your sticky butt. You try to take my eye. You try to make me blind in one eye. Well, I see more with my eyes closed than you'll ever see with yours open. And you want to know something? An eye for an eye. That ain't good enough for me. But two is.
That's right, but two is. Let me tell you something, Eddie Gilbert. You sit here and you think you're top dog? Well, you're nothing but the run of the litter. And Hawk and I know it. And that whole crew of yours. Bring them on! Because I've got the toughest man in the world on my side.
What a rush. Wow, incredible, Fed! Road Warrior Hawk!
Lock. You better lock the door to this boat here.
You know, I said I'd do this, and, somebody wants to be a little cute. Matt, come here. Come here right now. Come here. Let's look at the format. Here. What does it say? It says The Adventures of the King. It doesn't say anything about Terry Funk or the Wolfman or Hawk or anybody like that. It says The Adventures of the King. That's what everyone wants to see, okay? Everyone wants to see me. They don't want to see anyone else, okay? Okay, Matt? All right?
All right.
Please, go do the job. Let's do it. People, just think of it like this. Eddie's World, Party Time, excellent. Now let's see The Adventures of the King of Philadelphia.
We are here in this outdoor cafe where a woman is actually trying to marry the king to be his queen.
Not tonight, okay? I'm sorry, honey, all right? But maybe someday, not now, you know. Take a number and get in line, okay? Okay?
Here, give the king some flowers.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. What's your name again?
Rosemary.
There was somebody. Paul, help me now. Trivia here. Rosemary, didn't she star on the Dick Van Dyke Show?
That was it. Rosemary,
right? Was you named after her?
No.
How do you know that? Your mom and dad may have been. Anyway, what?
Put this clown over here.
Who is that?
I don't know. Yeah. He's blind as that referee.
Yeah, what's his name?
Hey,
Joe.
Come here. Come over here.
You.
Yeah, you.
Come over here.
Yeah.
Rose, can we bring you here just a second? Thank you, Rose. Nice girl, that Rose. Just didn't realize how many I've had. But anyway.
How many what?
I don't remember.
What's your problem?
Oh!
Wow, it's the Elephant Man. What's your problem?
Yeah, I was just walking down the street and I saw the king here.
Hey, you mind doing us a favor and take those Coke bottles off your face?
It's very funny. I was just walking down the street and I saw this guy in the king crown. He obviously was somebody important, and I just wanted to stop by.
Say that again. Someone important?
Somebody who's important, so I just wanted to stop
somebody
by.
Somebody important, ladies and gentlemen. Me, moi.
Well, if he says he is, he's got to be. I mean, anybody that wears a crown,
Don't you know who this man is?
Well, he's got a southern accent. He's got a crown on his head. It can only be one person. I live in New York, and it's got to be Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert.
See, this guy knows who the king of Philadelphia is. Where are you from?
I'm from Cooperstown, New York. I've heard a lot about him, and I had to see the crown.
Hey, you know what I want you to do? Kiss the king's hand.
Now, wait a minute. We got a TV here. You want me to kiss his hand?
Can I say something first, though? You know who I thought he was?
Who?
I thought he was that before picture on the before and after shot of John Arezzi, like before he lost all that weight.
I'm sorry. Anyway,
go ahead. Kiss his hand.
Why don't I ask the people? You guys think I should kiss his hand?
Yes. Tell him.
Come over here. Come over here. Yeah. Yeah, come here. Come here.
Mama Bell.
That's it. Goodbye. We don't need you no more. We're going to talk to this. We're going to talk to this big, good-looking fella.
How you doing?
With the haircut like.
How you doing?
Yeah. That's
how you doing?
You all right?
What's up?
No,
who are you, man?
We're good. Huh?
I know you're arrested, but who are you?
Oh, well, first hit. What's on my head?
You're what's King.
Yeah.
Wait. King Vitamin.
No, I only King. Kiss the King's hand.
I can't kiss his hand, man.
Why not?
Skirt, you know what I mean?
Oh, so if he wore a skirt, you'd kiss his hand.
But you would kiss a nice-looking woman's hand, right?
Yeah. Hey, don't be going to find nobody, you know what I mean?
I ain't
You're too cool for that, aren't you?
Yeah. I'm just out having a good time, you know what I mean?
Well, just remember that the King of Philadelphia is Eddie Gilbert.
Eddie Gilbert?
Yeah.
Oh, you that wrestling guy.
That's right.
And get out of here.
And this is Paul E. Dangerously.
Get out of here.
You understand?
Hey, y'all need details?
Good.
What are you
saying? Good
man. Kiss his hand. I can't kiss. I'll shake it. I can't kiss. All right, my man.
All right, man.
Take it easy. Have fun, all right?
Take it easy.
Don't drink and drive.
All you and the rest of my associates out there in Philly.
Don't forget,
Pete. Hey, you know what?
Eastern Championship Wrestling is brought to you in part by Carver W. Reed, your Quality Plus Ford dealers, and Soloflex. Tell them you saw them on Eastern Championship Wrestling.
Dick Gregory for the Bahamian Diet. The problem is you're overweight, whether it's 10 pounds or 150 pounds. Hey, I've been there, and the solution is simple. The Bahamian Diet. Mix it with fruit juice, drink it for breakfast and lunch, eat a well-balanced meal for dinner, drink 8 glasses of water every day, and walk a mile every day. Hey, that's all it is to it. Don't wait. Start right now. You can do it. I know. I've been there, and it ain't pretty.
Available at GNC and most health stores.
The new 93 Ranger is now at your Quality Plus Ford dealer.
No other truck is built for tough.
Now lease an all-new, well-equipped, number one selling 93 Ford Ranger for just $199 a month for 24 months with no money down. It's got a slick new look inside and out. Hurry, lease a Ranger for just $199 per month for 24 months with no money down. 5 of the top 10 sellers in America are at your Quality Plus Ford dealer.
Hit the ground running in a new Ford truck. Hey, hey.
There is a big difference between weightlifting and all other forms of exercise. Aerobics and sports are fine for tone and endurance, but only weightlifting will make your muscles grow. Soloflex, unlike many of its imitators, is true weightlifting because it is isotonic. Isotonic exercise provides positive and negative resistance. Resistance on the power stroke and resistance on the return stroke. Isokinetic exercise is positive resistance only, cheating you out of half the exercise, cheating you out of building muscle. Soloflex will allow you to do those negative reps, and it's the negative reps that are responsible for virtually all muscle growth. Soloflex, if you're serious about your body. Now only $39 down and $39 a month. Call now for a free Soloflex brochure.
Third
third of the tag team champions, the Suicide Blondes, Sir Jonathan Hotbody, facing off against the Sandman with Miss Peaches at ringside.
Well, this ought to be a tremendous contest because Sir Jonathan Hotbody, one third of the Suicide Blondes, one half of the ECW Tag Team Champions, going in a singles match against the Sandman, the ECW former heavyweight champion, with a beautiful arm drag. But, you know, I think the Sandman is making a big mistake.
What's that, Paulie? What
you
mistake
never
did he make?
Trust your career to a broad.
Miss Peaches is always there by the Sandman's side. She's been nothing but a great help to him in past weeks here, Paulie.
Yeah, well, she's been a great help because of one thing and one thing only. Because Miss Peaches, quite frankly, Jay Sully, well, she's a tramp.
She's a lady, Paulie Dangerously. She's a lady.
Well, then the lady is a tramp.
Incredible fan. The Sandman now bringing Jonathan Hotbody back into the ring the hard way. It looks like, oh, no, a clubbing forearm to Sir Jonathan Hotbody. Hunter Q Robbins outside now trying to encourage Jonathan Hotbody on here, Paulie.
Well, what do you think he's going to do? The man has a financial interest in the Suicide Blondes. Now, look at the dumb move by the Sandman. That's why you never put your career in the hands of a broad. He just broke the count. He could win the match by count out, but oh no, he has to go over there and break the count.
I thought we decided Miss Peaches is a lady, Paulie.
No, you decided. There's no we involved. Whoa! He's pulling him in by his hair!
Also precarious position here for Sir Jonathan Hotbody, the referee.
He better break it or the ref is going to DQ.
Oh, and broke it he did. Sir Jonathan Hotbody slammed to the mat. Incredible, fans.
You know, why does the Sandman, every time he does something, why does he then go to the fans and raises his hand?
I think he draws energy from the crowd there, Paulie.
Well, that energy is doing him a lot of good now against Sir Jonathan Hotbody.
Throwing the Sandman out of the ring, almost on top of his manager, Hunter Q Roberts III. Oh, Hunter Q a little upset, putting the boots to the Sandman.
No. He's just wiping his shoe. I mean, look at that doormat laying there. I mean, he's just wiping off his shoe. I mean, you know, if you're going to cover up your whole body, that's what happens. Wham! Beautiful kick to the face. Back to the violence. That's what I like. The manager comes at, whoa!
Jonathan Hotbody, a flying elbow drop off the ring apron. Incredible. What a move. The Sandman outside the ring. Unbelievable, Paulie.
That's what I like. Let the manager work out his frustrations. Get back to the violence by the wrestlers. This is my type of action.
Irish whip of the Sandman across the ring. Oh, it looks like a sleeper. It is, Paulie.
It's a sleeper hold, which is the Sandman's favorite maneuver. Sir Jonathan Hotbody has stolen the favorite maneuver of the Sandman.
Incredible, fans. This is a submission hold. The referee moving into... There's one.
One. It could be all over. There's two. One more. And Hotbody wins.
Oh, no. Now the Sandman able to hang on here. That was close, Paulie, but the Sandman still hanging on.
Yeah, but for how much longer as Hotbody cranks down on that sleeper?
Miss Peach is outside the ring, encouraging now the Sandman on. Here she is up on the ring apron now. Sandman rebounds himself. Oh, a nice clothesline on Jonathan Hotbody. Outside the ring goes one third of the Suicide Blondes. Sandman right back outside, bringing Jonathan Hotbody right back into the middle of the ring. Whips Jonathan across. Oh, looks like he was going for a body slam, but oh, there's Hunter Q Robbins up on the ring. What's that, a cane to the throat, Paulie? You saw it.
Yeah, I saw it plain as day. So what?
Once again, illegal outside interference on the part of Hunter Q Robbins III, enabling Jonathan Hotbody to gain advantage of here.
It's all over. Watch this.
One. Cover. There's one.
Two.
Oh, the Sandman able to reverse. There's one. There's two. There's three. Incredible, fan. The Sandman victorious here in the ECW.
Your winner, the Sandman.
Whoa, look at this. Look at this. Now, this is the type of action that I like. A cat fight.
The Rockin'
yeah, Rebels.
Oh,
go.
What's going on here? Tigra, the Rockin' Rebels holding Miss Peaches, and Tigra's literally stripping the clothes right off of Miss Peaches. Oh, my goodness, fans. Unbelievable. We've got to get out of here.
Yeah, this is my type of cat fight.
Wow, we'll be right back, fans. Thank
no,
you.
No, let's stay where we are.
Oh, unbelievable, fans. The Sandman covering Miss Peaches up and working her way back to the dressing room. Thank you.
Don't forget, fans, the next ECW television taping extravaganza, August 7th and 8th at the ECW Arena. Starting time, 7 p.m. both nights. The bad man from Borger, Texas returns. The man who broke Bruno's neck, Stan the Lariat Hansen, is back. Formerly one half of the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Shane Douglas makes his ECW debut. Self-proclaimed King of Philadelphia, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert returns from his tour of Philadelphia to defend his crown. Former WWF Intercontinental and Tag Team Champion Tito Santana will be in action. Sensational Sherry makes her ECW debut. Paul E. Dangerously, along with a whole Dangerous Alliance, including heavyweight champ The Magnificent Morocco, TV champion Jimmy Superfly Snuka, and the mysterious Dark Patriot. Ivan and Vladimir Koloff return, and of course, the wild man Sal Balomo will be there to greet all the kids. A two-night tournament to crown the new ECW Tag Team Champions, along with all the other top stars in the ECW. That's August 7th and 8th at the ECW Arena in South Philadelphia, 7 p.m. bell time. For more information, call the ECW hotline at 544-0421. The action's going to be hot August 7th and 8th.
W. Reed, corner of 10th and Sansom Street, since 1860.
The future of sports television is about to dramatically change. A revolution is going to take place, and a new voice will be heard. That new voice is News Sports, an alternative 24-hour sports news and information service. News Sports delivers more than just scores and highlights. News Sports takes you to the game. It goes behind the scenes and gives you the chance to speak out. News Sports. Your alternative source is coming this fall to cable TV.
Why is Isuzu America's number one selling low-cab forward truck? Over 150 vocational applications.
O'Connor Truck Sales, the number one Isuzu dealer in the tri-state area.
This is Paul E. Dangerously. Not that I need an introduction, but if you want to know the latest in the ECW, pick up your phone. Dial 215-544-0421. How's that, huh?
Yeah, hold on just a second. That pardon me, Richie Coat Tight, whatever he's the coach of, you know, the Eagles, you know. I told you that's what was going to happen, you know. Reggie left, and then, you know, and then, you know, Keith Dash went to the Dolphins, and Keith Byers, you know, he got mad at you. You know, the close relationship with the guys. Anyway, I got to go now. That TV show I'm trying to do, it's my show here. You don't have one, I do. Okay, bye. Thank you. Anyway, thank you, everyone, and back to my show. I'd like everyone to know that, you know, throughout my career, I've been known as a lot of things. A lot of people call me a lot of names, and a lot of times they may be right, and sometimes they may not be right. One thing I am, though, is the Legend Slayer, and the way that I became that name and got that reputation, it was first down in Memphis, Tennessee a few years ago. A guy carried a crown around quite like mine. His name was Jerry Lawler, and, well, I did away with Jerry Lawler, and he runs around in some organization now with a Burger King crown on. And then along came Terry Funk, the great legendary Terry Funk. And then he wrestled me here in Philadelphia, and what did I do to him in his own Texas chain match? I beat him and became the King of Philadelphia. And you know, then I've been having this problem within the city with all these celebrity sporting figures I've heard about, with the Flyers and the Eagles and the Phillies, and John Crook has been giving me, he's like trying to make me have a nervous breakdown around here and everything. Well, then I was at this celebrity thing the other day, over at this Eagles Nest thing,
And Ron Jaworski, this big legend supposed to be here, he tried picking on me. And this made news throughout the city and actually national publicity. Ron Jaworski tried picking on me, the legend player, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. And I just wish I had that tape to show you right now. But I don't. But what I am going to show you, what I am going to show you right now is me against another legend. Bruno Sammartino. Yeah, Bruno Sammartino. Let's take a look at that right now. Me against Bruno. Yeah. Me against Bruno. Bruno.
He is the self-proclaimed King of Philadelphia. This is...
Wait a minute.
Huh? Self-proclaimed, this is the King of Philadelphia. And if anybody has any doubts about it, all you have to do is ask Terry Funk, who went back to Texas with his tail between his legs. Now, I know all of you people have been just sitting here waiting with bated breath to see the king take apart another one of these so-called, well, I won't even mention it. But unfortunately, last night in Minneapolis, Minnesota, the king, your king, was injured in a match with that coward, Road Warrior Hawk, when he pulled out a foreign object and hit him in the head. Now, the king did not want to disappoint his subject. He wanted to come out here and wrestle, but according to the doctor's orders and my orders, he cannot do so today. So, I know you're all disappointed, but that's tough. Take it, little man.
Sorry.
Listen, first off, it was a great pleasure for me to come out here and see all you feeble-minded people today to show that you are and can be really good-hearted people by coming out here for such a good cause. The greatest cause to me here today is me. I won the title of the King of Philadelphia. I am sorry to all the adoring fans that showed up here today to want to see me wrestle, but the doctor said I couldn't wrestle. Hunter Q said I couldn't wrestle. So I can't wrestle the match today. I'm so sorry. At least I did show up. At least I did show up to have my picture taken. At least I did show up to sign the autograph for all the little kids here and all the grown-ups that look up to me as their idol, like the Ron Jaworskis and the Reggie Whites and all these so-called heroes around here. So what I'm telling you is, I am not able to wrestle today, and that's it, okay? Put that in your little pipe and smoke it. What's it? You have a filter? It's a winner.
Wait a minute! We didn't talk about any forfeit here. Now listen to me. You left me on the side of the You want to win? Count!
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 One!
Hey, your winner, the King of Philadelphia, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert.
Hey, referee, come here.
Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
I want everyone's attention to this one just a second. I saw someone here just a while ago. And I had a little conversation with such this big legend around here a while ago. And it seems to me there's a little argument going on here today. Who is the King of Philadelphia? There's this legendary quarterback that everyone called... What?
4 o'clock. It's still 2 seconds to get
in there. Was the fan club set up over here, all two of you? Well, what I want to say is right now is Mr. Ron Jaworski, our God himself, has the guts, has the audacity to come up to this ring right now and get in the ring with the true King of Philadelphia, and let's see who the King of Philadelphia is, Mr.
Go!
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Can you get right up in here right now?
All right, man. Who's that cook? Who's that cook?
You. Oh, so hey. Someone want to hold the robot door?
Take them apart.
I'd be more than happy, Mr. Gilbert.
One dealer can offer you five of the 10 best sellers in America, your Quality Plus Ford dealer. Now, Ford Cars is the number one selling car in America, a leader in safety with available dual airbags and anti-lock brakes. Ford Cars has been on Car and Driver's top 10 list 7 years straight. Now, for a limited time, get this loaded Taurus GL and save $1,200, including $500 cash back from Ford. Hurry, save on five of the top 10 sellers in America, only at your Quality Plus Ford dealer.
Dick Gregory for the Bahamian Diet.
The problem is you're overweight, whether it's 10 pounds or 150 pounds. Hey, I've been there, and the solution is simple. The Bahamian Diet. Mix it with fruit juice, drink it for breakfast and lunch, eat a well-balanced meal for dinner, drink 8 glasses of water every day, and walk a mile every day. Hey, that's all it is to it. Don't wait. Start right now. You can do it. I know. I've been there, and it ain't pretty.
Available at GNC and most health stores.
Today, a man came into the bank for a $500 loan. $500. Banks don't make loans that small. It's just too much paperwork. I told him, try a collateral loan. A pawnbroker. No paperwork and very fair interest rates. He said, pawnbrokers, are they reliable? I said, certainly. It's like any other business. You just have to be careful who you deal with.
Carver W. Reed, corner of 10th and Sansom Street, since 1860.
You know, I just said here through this commercial break, and I was just thinking, you know, David Letterman with his show with Hal Gurney as director, he never got treated with no respect. And, you know, and like Johnny Carson had his show, and Jay Leno now with his show, and Arsenio Hall with his show, I know the director, I always treat him with respect. I get no respect here, Matt. Every time I ask you, how many times did I go to the format with you? I told you I've had it with you, Matt. You won't listen to what I tell you. You don't ever say anything and everything.
Oh, Matt.
Well, hello, Jay. How you doing, Jay? Jay Sully's here with us now, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, Jay. Jay Sully.
Jay. I show up and he's here.
Jay. Jay, have a seat. Hey, look what I picked. Hey, look. I got you some Dunkin' Donuts.
Are you making a comment on the weight line, Eddie?
No, just thought you might be hungry, that's all. How you been, Jay?
Matt,
where you been, Jay?
Matt, 1 o'clock, I got a message from Tod Gordon to be here at 3. You know, what's going on? Eddie Gilbert show? What is this, your show now?
Just need to buy what?
Unbelievable. Matt, I thought I was the host of the Eastern Championship Wrestling. I thought you wanted me here to do the openings. I show up and he's here. You know, what's he doing?
He was here all day.
We've had a great show, Jay, without you here, okay? It's been my show. Yes, it has been. All the people loved it. Matt loved it, didn't you, Matt? Just say yes. Say yes. Yes, you loved it. And then we didn't need you here. I don't know. Did Ty call you? Did Tod Gordon call and tell you what time to be here?
Yes, Tod Gordon. And in fact, I'm 20 minutes. And I'm early.
You early?
Yes, I'm early. And you've already finished everything, Matt?
Well, I'll just tell you what, Jay. Let's just ask all the fans out here, and we'll just let everyone know that I think that I did a king of a job.
Well, I have no idea what, you know, how this is going to come out, and I'm going to be sure to head home and take a look for myself. But hopefully, fans, I'll be back in charge next week. I'll be back as your regular host for Eastern Championship Wrestling.
Oh, let's hope so.
We'll see you next week, fans.